What's happening, guys? Keith here with another Impact Wrestling review. So today we're going to take a look at the November 17th edition of Explosion. This is my first Explosion review on the page. If this is your first time visiting the channel, make sure to hit that subscribe button along with that notify bell. Moving forward, I plan to do these weekly, possibly alternating this with the press pass, or maybe I'll do both. I got a lot going on in my life, so I try to fit as much Impact Wrestling on the page as possible. But yeah, hopefully I will be able to cover this each week, depending on how well viewed this is and the reception from all you guys. So please let me know if you'd like me to continue to do these. So we have LAX versus Tarik and Brett Banks. Each week it is a mystery where the match on Explosion will take place. This time it took place in the Rebel Complex in Canada. So this was either the post-Slammiversary tapings in July or the August tapings. I'm guessing it's probably August because I believe after LAX's match with the OGs at Slammiversary, they were pretty heavily bandaged. So I know they made reference to the Axe segment, which I believe was August, correct me if I'm wrong. So, yeah, I mean, the commentary doesn't necessarily line up with exactly where we are. I noticed a couple weeks back when Josh Alexander wrestled Killer Cross, the commentary was solely based on what was going on in the ring, so it could have fit in anywhere. This one, they were talking a little bit about the LAX versus Young Bucks on the Jericho Cruise, which actually happened almost a month ago now, but they were making it sound as if it was just happening or about to happen, so just a little small gripe of mine. But again, in the U.S., these are only available on the Global Wrestling Network, so pretty much if you're a fan of Impact and have the network, you're going to watch it. So, Tarik and Banks, though, worked well together. They isolated Ortiz early on in the match. Ortiz gets the hot tag to Santana. Santana goes to work for a bit. The two of them end up hitting that combination moonsault and leg drop on Banks. Tarik is able to break that up. We saw them use that against Falaba and KM last week on Impact. But like I said, yeah, heavy promoting of the Young Bucks and LAX match. Ortiz went to hit a sunset flip on Banks, and rather than rolling him forward into a pinning position, he rolled backwards, and Santana was able to kick Banks. It was just more innovative offense by LAX. These guys always, I feel, insert a new maneuver into their arsenal every match. They go back and forth a little bit, both teams, and the finish saw Banks going for a superplex. Santana pushes him off. Ortiz grabs him, hits him with a Death Valley driver. Santana hits a frog splash, and LAX gets the win. No surprise here, but overall a decent match. Then we had Around the Ring with Rich Swann. This was recorded in the Melrose Ballroom in New York. They had said that considering everything took place in one area, they had to be quiet about it, because normally I guess they are able to tape segments in other areas of the arena. But like I said, with the Melrose Ballroom, like, we saw a lot of the LAX skits take place at the bar, which was literally, I don't know, 30 feet away from the ring on either side. But Rich is asked if he records his own music, which he says he does not. He says he listens to alternative rock and R&B. His favorite song is Nutshell by Alice in Chains. Rich says he translates his music to wrestling. With his music, he likes to take songs and kind of put his own spin on it. And with wrestling, he takes people's maneuvers and makes them into his own variation. He has been wrestling for 12 years. He started training in York, Pennsylvania under Adam Flash and Ray Alexander. He was born in Baltimore, then moved to Pennsylvania, and now lives in Florida, which seems like a lot of people do, wrestler-wise. He's asked what he wants to accomplish next. He says he wants to wrestle on the biggest stages that he can, and his goal is to become Impact World Champion. He makes mention, because of his size, that, you know, it'll be something if he becomes champion. He says he used to use the standing 450 as his finisher, but now he uses the Phoenix Splash because the 450 is not considered, or the standing 450 is not considered that impactful anymore. And he says the Phoenix Splash is a tribute to Hayabusa. And he talks about Impact Wrestling a little bit, and he says that everyone is a family. They're all working together to get the product to the top. Everybody is hungry and trying to prove themselves. So I like that they do this. It's a staple on the Explosion show. Kind of lines up with the press pass. We get a little more background information on the guys, a little about what they do in their personal life, things like that. I like the segment. It's pretty cool. And then we had Bobby Roode versus AJ Styles versus James Storm, a number one contenders match from Turning Point 2012. So this match happened during my 10-year break from wrestling. I stopped watching wrestling from probably about 2005 to about 2015. So it was a match that I haven't seen. So I always like to see what actually happened when I wasn't watching. I definitely noticed how lively the Impact Zone was and the fact that they had advertisements all over the ring and on the ring skirt. I'm not sure if this was when TNA Impact was going through a identity crisis, because this Tron and the ring all said TNA, and then you saw all posters in the background that said Impact Wrestling, along with a lot of the shirts in the audience were Impact Wrestling. It's weird watching a match and not seeing Bullet Club shirts all over the place. But yeah, this was a decent match. I enjoyed it. It probably was not the main event of the show because it was only a number one contenders match. But the beginning portion of the match was generally one-on-one. One guy would take out the third guy, and the other two would battle it out. AJ hit a nice flip dive to Roode and Storm on the outside. Storm hit a double jawbreaker on Roode, which now is referred to as the Codebreaker. It's just funny how things change. AJ capitalizes on the opportunity. He hits James Storm with a phenomenal forearm, which is also now his finisher and was just a part of his arsenal in TNA. Storm kicks out. We saw both James Storm and Bobby Roode go for a double suplex on AJ. They kind of played the whole beer money thing since obviously they were split up at this point. The crowd got into it, and then they end up attacking each other because he thought that they were possibly going to get back together and double team AJ, but that did not happen. We had a nice spot where Bobby Roode was sitting up on the turnbuckle. AJ came running at James Storm. James Storm elevated him up over himself. He hits Bobby Roode with a Hurricane Rana. Roode is able to hit a blockbuster on James Storm for a near fall. AJ goes for the 450 on Bobby Roode. He misses. Roode hits him with a spear. He gets a near fall. Roode was setting up AJ for the fisherman suplex. Storm comes in, hits Roode with a lung blower, and then hits AJ with the last call for the win, and that was that. Then we had the X Division Championship from last week between Brian Cage and Sami Callihan. If you guys didn't check out my review of last week's show, you can do so. It is available on the channel. But yeah, that was pretty much the show. I really think Impact Wrestling can utilize Explosion better. They really should put lower card talent on the show, just because it's hard to get all your talent onto TV when you only have 2 hours a week to do it, and a roster that, you know, that you have new guys coming in, you got guys that you want to get on TV that aren't always able to be on the show. I mean, how many times do we see talent not show up? We didn't see Grado, Joe Hendry, Caleb Conley over when we were in New York. And I'm sure that'll be the case in the Vegas tapings as well. I'd like to see them get rid of the classic match. Just put another current match in that spot, one that they tape for Explosion. I mean, you can just have another GWN flashback in this spot. That's fine. But the fact that they dedicate time to a full match that has no bearing on the current product just doesn't make sense to me. I get they want to showcase their history, but that's why we have the Global Wrestling Network. What I was going to say. Oh, while Cage and Callihan was the main event from this week, I'd rather see them do a full, like, a recap of the show. I mean, we did have the Knockouts Championship match that was made for Homecoming, which was a pretty big deal. A bunch of other things happened as well. And I really like to see them be able to put this on their YouTube channel. Just have it spotlighting some talent. You have a recap of the previous week. I mean, I'm not sure if they could even do this because I believe in some parts of the world, Explosion still airs on network TV. So I'm sure they probably wouldn't be able to do that. I mean, if they were able to move it to YouTube, that would probably be the best idea, as they've had a huge upswing in viewers on their YouTube page. Last year, in October, they hit the 1 million subscriber mark. They're about to hit the 2 million subscriber mark now. They have 1,970,000 subscribers right now. I'm going to do a special on Impact Wrestling's YouTube page once they hit that 2 million subscriber mark. I have a whole bunch of analytics and stuff like that that really shows how much it has taken off. But I think people would be able to tune in more to the YouTube channel to watch this. And then you could just promote the Thursday night show on Pop TV. It's just a simple way to do it. You have 2 million subscribers. There's a good chance you're going to get people to tune in and new people that are going to check out Pop on Thursday night. But again, just what I would like to see from Explosion. I think they have the show set up there. You might as well use it to push the current product forward. Yeah, that's pretty much all I have for you guys. Let me know what you thought about my review. Leave me comments to let me know what you guys would do with the Explosion show in order to help Impact Wrestling push forward. I will see you guys tomorrow for the review of the Thanksgiving special of Impact. And until then, thanks for checking out my video, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thanks, guys. Bye. Did you like that video? If so, click here to check out more great content. Thank you for supporting the Clock Cleaners Podcast.